time now to take you straight to Kudankulam, where anti-nuclear fire is raging. Arvind Kejriwal,
and they also took away money from these people. One of the person here just now said that they took away, one of the women said they took away 20,000 rupees. One of the women said they took away 4,500 rupees. Now where should all these people go? Where should all these people go and register FIRs? If the police themselves is doing all this, then where should the people go? I'm also told that we are all right now sitting in a church. The building behind us is a church. In this church, day before yesterday, the police came and they broke the idols. It is also alleged, is that right, Father, that they urinated in the church?
Yeah, urinated in the stage here.
On the stage here. Now this is completely unacceptable. This is not right. This is not maintenance of law and order. This is complete terror that Jayalalitha government has unleashed on her own people, the people who voted her to power. How can Jayalalitha do this to her own people? I am told that 40 boats of poor fishermen have been destroyed by the police. Is this maintenance of law and order? Which law gives the power to the police to destroy the boats of poor fishermen? Each boat costs 4 lakh rupees. Now where would a poor fisherman get a boat from? His livelihood is completely destroyed. I am told that 34 motorcycles have been broken by the police. Which law gives police the power to break motorcycles? Is this maintenance of law and order? I am told that 53 people have been arrested in the last 2 days. They have imposed sections 121. 121 is waging a war against state. You think these poor people have the capacity to wage war against the state? Is Jayalalitha waging a war against the state, or these poor people are waging a war against the state? Is UPA government sitting in the center and thrusting a nuclear plant on these people? Are they waging a war against the people of this country, or are these poor people waging a war against the state? 124A section has been imposed on them. This is sedition. Are these people, unarmed people, poor people, capable of sedition? Everywhere in the country, Vasim Trivedi makes some cartoons and protests against corruption. He is charged with sedition. Here, S.P. Uday Kumar is charged with sedition. The poor people protesting against a bad nuclear plant, they are charged with sedition. Everyone in this country is being charged with sedition. 307, attempt to murder. These poor people, it is being alleged that they tried to murder the police. There can't be a bigger joke than this. How can you impose section 307 on completely unarmed people? 53 people, including 7 women, have been charged with attempt to murder. 300 police cases have been slapped against Uday Kumar. Similarly, I am told that there are 5 such people against whom 300 cases have been slapped. It seems he seems to be the most wanted person in this country by the police, by the state. And I am very happy that I am standing by his side. This is completely a police terror that has been unleashed on the people by Jayalalitha government. I am told 1.5 lakh people in this area face police cases. What are these people asking for? These people are just saying that this nuclear plant is not safe. Please have all safety measures. Is it wrong to demand adequate safety measures from a nuclear plant?